Today we are making another animated movie poster. This one, as you just saw, is for Inception. Inception is a captivating 2010 science fiction action film masterfully crafted by the visionary director Christopher Nolan. For those of you who haven't yet witnessed its magic, let me set the stage. Inception delves into a world where dreams are not just figments of imagination, but powerful tools. Our protagonist, a skilled thief, infiltrates minds using cutting-edge dream-sharing technology. His mission? To implant an idea deep within the consciousness of a cooperated titan. But as the layers of dreams unfold, so do the shadows of our hero's past, embodied by the enigmatic Leonardo DiCaprio. Will the project succeed, or will tragedy befall the team? Well, you need to watch it to get the answer. Anyhow, Nolan's signature style influences every frame of this film. Prepare for groundbreaking special effects and mesmerizing visuals. Today, let's zoom in on one particular marvel, the awe-inspiring bending building effect. Now, this tutorial is part of a series where I revisit my favorite film, seeking out those exhilarating aha moments. But this isn't a step-by-step tutorial. Well, maybe some steps, but not all of them. Instead, I'll peel back the layers, revealing my creative process and workflow. And my hope is to inspire you and perhaps unveil a few hidden gems you didn't know existed. Now let's address the technical constraints first. Composition size is set to a canvas of 1400 by 1800 pixels, a waste for our artistic touch. The duration? Well, I'm going to keep it concise, not more than 10 seconds to captivate the audience. The tool of choice is After Effects, of course, armed with an army of its plugins. Race against time, I need to complete the project within a tight 3-hour window. So, get ready to dream, create, and bend reality. Welcome to the world of Inception. So to create the high street skyscrapers, I've used Video Copilot's Element 3D. This plugin is 10 years old now, but it is still one of my favorite bridges between 2D and 3D, especially for After Effects. Not only creating bridges, but as you will witness in a moment, it can also bend them. So before I start, I found out that Element, at least on my machine with this version of After Effects, doesn't like the cache frames when ideal option. So before I'll jump into the plugin interface, I'll switch it off under the composition menu, preview options, and here it is. Okay, now I'll enable the effect and click on the scene setup, which is where you build, import, and texture your 3D geometry, as well as bring other stuff. And then I'll show you what I've already set up for this example. Now, I'm using assets from the Metropolitan pack that has over 100 3D models of different buildings. You can get it at the Video Copilot website. You can see that we have offices, skyscrapers with or without antennas, and some of them are suitable for day as well as night look. So what I did is laid down a row of various buildings and arranged them in two main lines. So the skyscrapers are first blocking, of course, the views of the lower roof buildings that were there probably a long time before they were built. Anyhow, after meticulously placing these buildings without any approval from the council, I've made sure that all of them will be part of group number one. So we can control up to 5 groups inside After Effects. I'll show you how to do it in a moment. But next, I want to show you that I've duplicated this group and then flip those buildings and then move some of them and rearrange them so they're not going to look as a duplicated mirror. And then I assigned the folder for this one to group number 2. So I'll click OK to return to After Effects, and then I'll switch to Custom View 1. This is a bird's eye view to our composition. Now, since we are viewing the comp from this custom view, we can't see any 2D layers that I already have in the timeline. So this is, of course, the Inception title. But if I'll reselect the Element 3D layer and then open up Custom Layers and twirl down Custom Text and Masks, we can see that this text is being defined as path layer number 1. So back in the scene setup inside Element, we can see that this is assigned to the title group, which is already set to group number 3. And over here, we can design and extrude this text the way we want, which is what I did ahead of time. So I'll click OK again, and I'll enable now group number 3. And now we can have a look at everything together. Oh, by the way, if you are enjoying this video and you find it useful, please like it and also subscribe to the channel. Otherwise, I must send Terence after you, and he's not someone you want to mess with.
You tell him I'm coming! Tell him I'm f***ing coming!
Oh, wait there are children watching. Please forgive me. Okay, back to After Effects. Let's create the bending distortion. To do it, I'll open up group number 1 options, and under the particle look, I'll open the deform. Here we can enable bend, and I'll set the bend axis to Y for this case. Then I'll set a keyframe at 1, 0 with the current 0 degrees value and move to, let's say, 6 seconds. Over here, we can set it to negative 120 degrees. Now I'm going to do the same for group number 2. But in this case, the first keyframe, of course, is going to be 0, but the second one, under 6 seconds, is going to be just 120, because we need the opposite, the mirror effect. I'll select both keyframes and press F9 to easy ease them, so it will be a bit more smooth in terms of the animation. And then I'll go to the end of the timeline, and over here we can see that this effect isn't smooth, it's not perfect, due to the fact that we don't have enough segments for the 3D geometry to bend. But for this instance, I think it will suffice. We are also going to view this from a tighter angle, so it won't be as noticeable. Now, I'll turn the shy guy icon in the timeline off, and this will reveal the camera, which is already animated using a null object, as well as a spotlight that I've placed ahead of time, and a couple of sound effects that I will enable shortly. But now, let's preview the animation, and as you can see, the camera path is basically a pan up and then orbiting on top of those buildings as they bend, and in between, we can see the name of the movie. Okay, now to make it look better, I'll turn on the spotlight, which is set to cast shadows, and then I'll return to the Element 3D layer and enable shadows in the render settings of this effect. I'll also turn on the ambient occlusion and set the screen space ambient occlusion, which is SSAO. I'll set the intensity of it to 10, just to make it a bit more stronger. Then I'll enable fog, which is a great way to dim the furthest building in the distance. So I'll set the fog opacity to 100% and the fog start distance to 1000. I'm also going to set the fall type to exponential, and this of course will help to hide the buildings in the distance and will create a nice fall off effect. Finally, under the output section, I'll raise the multi-sampling to 16 and super sampling to 2 to improve the render quality. And that's it! Let's turn on the speaker icon next to these two sound effects clips and then maximize this composition viewer and preview this comp. And this is it. A small tribute to this magnificent film as a token of appreciation from me and from Element 3D. If you didn't see the movie, make sure to do it before the next time we'll meet. And until then, take care, thank you for watching, and I will see you again soon.